What's up, everybody? My name is Justin.
And I'm Brianna.
And welcome to Valley Creek Kids. Come on, wherever you're watching from, would you make some noise for all of our friends that are watching with us?
Woo, yeah. Now it's game time.
This game is called Stand Up If. Everyone starts by sitting down, and then we're going to say something. And if that applies to you, then you're gonna go ahead and stand up, all right?
All right. So wherever you're watching from, we want you to play. Whether you're watching from home or in one of our kids' rooms, or if you're in the car and you can't stand, raise your hand, okay? All right, let's play. Everybody go ahead and start by sitting down. Are you sitting? Okay, are you ready for our first statement? Here we go.
All right, guys, stand up if you like dogs more than cats.
I'm standing.
I'm for sure standing because I almost feel like everybody should be standing. All right. Okay, so go ahead and sit back down. All right, are you ready for the next one?
Mm-hmm.
Stand up if you're wearing purple.
Not either of us.
So we stay sitting.
Yeah.
All right, sit back down. Okay, stand up if you have a brother or a sister.
Oh, we both get to stand.
Yeah, we're both standing. All right, sit back down. Here we go. Stand up if you like pie more than cake. Yeah. I think we'd both be sitting that
yeah.
one. All right, sit down. Stand up if you play an instrument.
Oh, I wish I played an instrument.
Me too.
I can't
stand on that one. Good for you if you're standing, all right? Okay, so sit back down. Stand up if you have been on a roller coaster.
Ooh.
Yeah, Texas Titan.
Yeah.
I cried. All right. Sit back down. Stand up if you like pizza.
I love pizza.
Again, everyone should be standing. It's okay. There's all kinds of pizzas, so you can find one. Okay, sit back down. Stand up if you play a sport.
Used to. Doesn't
apply to us any longer. Okay, last question. Stand up if, and you guys, everyone gets to stand up for this one. Because stand up if you know that God is good, that Jesus has forgiven you, that you are loved, and that everything is possible.
Oh yeah, I'm standing.
Mm-hmm.
Even if you didn't know that, it's true for every single one of you. Thanks for playing that game with us. Now we're all going to stay standing and shout out those truths together. Here we go. Those are the truths that we can hold in our hearts forever.
That's right. Now stay standing because Jesus is here with us right now, and we're going to worship him together.
When we worship, we sing and we dance, but more importantly, we give Jesus the number one place in our heart. Let's focus our minds and hearts on him right now. Let's worship.
Your hope within me makes me be brave. I know your power gives me strength. So wherever I go, I'll carry hope. Because of Jesus, I can face my giants. Because of Jesus, I have victory. Because of Jesus, I can move the mountains. Because of Jesus, I carry hope with me. You're by my side, so wherever I go, I'll carry hope. Because of Jesus, I can face my giants. Because of Jesus, I have victory. Because of Jesus, I can move the mountains. Because of Jesus, I carry hope with me. Oh, I'll carry humble. You show me that all my fears are small. You show me that everything is possible. Because I know my God is big and strong, strong, strong. Because of Jesus, I can face my giants. Because of Jesus, I have victory. Because of Jesus, I can move the mountains. Because of Jesus, I carry hope with me. Because of Jesus, I can face my giants. Because of Jesus, I have victory. Because of Jesus, I can move the mountains. Because of Jesus, I carry hope with me. Because of Jesus, I carry hope with me. Because of Jesus, I carry hope with me.
Hey everyone, I'm Sarah. Thanks for worshiping with us. You can sit back down now because it's time to get started with our lesson. So, at Valley Creek Kids, we are a movement of hope. We're going to be saying the word hope a lot today. Does anyone know what it means?
Ah, according to my research, hope is expecting to see God's goodness in your life. Jesus is hope.
Yes, that's right. Thank you, Dr. Cassius. Okay, so at Valley Creek Kids, we are a movement of hope, which means that when we are full of hope, full of Jesus, full of the expectation to see God's goodness in our life, we don't just hold on to it and keep it to ourselves. No, we go out into the world and share that hope with others. And I don't know about you guys, but I want to share hope with people. What an amazing thing to share. So how do we do it? Where do we start?
You become a part of a movement of hope by first discovering Jesus.
Exactly, Dr. Cassius. We become part of a movement of hope when we start discovering Jesus. So that's what we're going to learn about today.
Did someone say discovering Jesus?
Yes. Hi, Argyle. Kids, this is our friend Argyle.
Hello, everyone.
And yes, Argyle, we are learning about discovering Jesus today.
Ah, yes, Jesus. I've heard that name before. I've read tales of him in my great big storybook. What's it called?
The Bible?
Ah, yes, the Bible.
Well, Argyle, guess what? Jesus isn't just a character in a book. He's a real person.
You're joking.
No, I'm not. All the stories about him in the Bible, they actually happened. Jesus is a real person who loves us and is here with us, ready for us to discover him.
Wow, he's here? I mean, where? I mean, I don't see him, Miss Sarah. Is he going to pop out from behind somewhere? I'm not scared or anything. I'm tough. If he did, it'd be fine.
Argyle,
I'm not worried. You know.
Argyle, it's okay. No one is popping out from anywhere. Jesus lives in our hearts. We can't see him, but he's with us always, and we were made to be with him. Actually, listen to what the Bible, God's word, says in Psalm 27:8. It says, Lord, when you say, seek my face, my heart says to you, your face, O Lord, I will seek.
Oh, I see. So this is like a game of hide and seek then. All right, we have to go look for Jesus.
No.
Come on, kids.
No, wait.
Jesus, come out, wherever you are.
Argyle, we're not playing hide and seek.
If it was me, I would hide in my best hiding spot, out in the woods. Maybe I should go look for him there.
No, Argyle, don't leave. Okay, guys. We're not playing hide and seek. Discovering Jesus is not like a game of hide and seek because Jesus isn't hiding from us.
He's not?
No. What I meant is that Jesus is here asking us to seek him, to discover him, and all we have to do is respond. You know what? Can I read you guys a story to help explain?
Oh, yes, of course. I love stories.
Okay. This is a Bible story, a story from God's word about when some of Jesus's friends, the disciples, first started their journey of discovering Jesus.
Oh boy, let's hear it.
Okay, here we go. This story is in the book of Matthew. Jesus was traveling. He was going around teaching people about God's love. One day, he was spending time with people along the shore of the Sea of Galilee when he noticed two brothers, Andrew and Peter. They were fishermen who had been working hard all day to catch fish. They were in the middle of casting a giant fishing net into the water when Jesus called out to them. He said, "Come follow me and I will send you out to fish for people." Jesus was inviting Andrew and Peter to come and discover him and to come help other people discover him too. He was inviting them to be part of the movement of hope. Right away, Andrew and Peter dropped their fishing nets and went to follow Jesus. From there, Jesus saw two other fishermen out in another boat named James and John. Jesus called out to them, just like he had to Andrew and Peter, and invited them to be part of the movement of hope too. Immediately, James and John left their boat and went to follow Jesus. The end.
So Jesus was inviting Andrew and Peter and James and John all to be a part of the movement of hope?
That's right. He invited them to follow him and come fish for people, to tell other people about who Jesus is and the hope that he offers. And it started with them choosing to say yes to discovering Jesus for themselves. They chose to leave their nets and leave their boats behind and say yes to Jesus's invitation.
Wow. It was the start of a great adventure.
Yeah, it was. And the invitation that Jesus had for them is the same one that he has for us. See, Jesus is inviting us to come and discover him too, to be part of his movement of hope.
Well, I want to be a part of that. What do I have to do? Just to gather supplies, like, you know, no. Some rope, a ladder, maybe add some spoons.
No, Argyle, you don't need any supplies. It's simple. We start by choosing to discover Jesus for ourselves, just like they did in the story.
Are you sure I don't need like a magnifying glass or a dictionary to help me learn about Jesus?
No, I promise you don't, Argyle, because choosing to follow Jesus and discover him isn't just choosing to learn about Jesus. It's choosing to know Jesus, to do life with him. See, in the story, Jesus was inviting the disciples to come with him. Well, that's what we get to do too. You can start by just saying, "Jesus, I need you."
Jesus, I need you.
Yeah.
Wait, for what?
Oh, well, we need Jesus in our life, Argyle. Jesus is the Son of God. He rescued the whole world, including us. We need him to guide us. We need his love. We need his forgiveness.
Forgiveness? What did I do to Jesus?
Nothing, Argyle. Listen, so we all miss the mark sometimes, right? We make a mistake or do something we aren't supposed to do. Well, that's called sin. And sin separated us from God and his best plan for our life. But because of Jesus, all of our sins are forgiven.
Oh yes, the Bible tells us this tale. It's a great story of love.
Yes, it does. The Bible tells us that God loves us so much that he didn't want to be separated from us. He wanted us to be part of his family. So he sent his son Jesus to earth to forgive all of our sins, and he did. So now, when we recognize that we need Jesus and we receive his forgiveness in our heart, we are fully forgiven and we get to live as God's loved kids, as part of his family.
Now that is incredible.
It really is. Okay, so to start discovering Jesus, the first thing we do is invite Jesus into our life by saying, "Jesus, I need you." Got it?
I've got it.
Okay, and we can keep telling Jesus that we need him every single day, Argyle, because discovering Jesus isn't just something that we do once and then we're done.
It's not?
No, discovering Jesus, well, there's always more to discover about Jesus. Even after we receive his forgiveness and become part of his family, we still need him every day.
Every day? Well,
yeah.
I better get started discovering.
Well, you already did just by being with us at Valley Creek Kids. See, we discover Jesus here by worshiping, by engaging God's word, and by talking to him.
Wow, and we do all those things in Valley Creek Kids?
Yeah, we do. Remember how we sang and danced earlier? Well, that's worship. Worship is when we make Jesus the most important thing in our life. We worship at Valley Creek Kids through music when we dance and sing about how amazing he is. And remember how we read the Bible story a few minutes ago? Well, that's engaging God's word, and it tells us all about Jesus. And then the last thing, talking to Jesus, well, we talk to Jesus every time we pray.
Wow, so every week when we're with Valley Creek Kids, we discover Jesus.
Yeah, that's right. And guess what, Argyle? Each of those things that you do with us, well, you can do anywhere, whenever you want.
I can worship Jesus anywhere? and talk to him anywhere? And read the Bible in the middle of the week?
You bet. If Jesus lives in our hearts and is with us everywhere we go, we can discover him anywhere, anytime. For example, worship. Just like how we worship here, you can worship Jesus anywhere. By singing and dancing to worship music, or by just stopping and telling him how grateful you are for him. Anything we do that makes Jesus the most important number one thing in our heart is worship.
So I can like sing to Jesus and I can thank him for the beef that I had for breakfast and maybe wait till a sculpture of him or something.
Sure, Argyle, that's great. When we worship Jesus, we discover more about him because we are spending time in his presence.
And what about the next one? Engaging in God's word.
Well, just like how we read the Bible here, you can read the Bible anywhere. You can ask someone in your family to read it to you, or read it with you, or you can talk about it together, or you can even pick just one scripture, one Bible verse, and read it and say it out loud. Maybe you could write it down. You can think about it all week long.
Ah, yes, I love the part about the sculpture. That was a good part.
Oh, no, scripture, Argyle. A Bible verse.
Yes, whatever. Anyway, and the last one was, talking to Jesus, and we can do that anywhere too?
Yeah, it's kind of hard to get to know someone if we never talk to them, right? So we can pray and talk to Jesus anytime, just like how we talk to a friend. There's no right or wrong way to pray. We can tell him thank you, or ask him questions, or ask for help, or just declare truths about who he is.
So I can discover Jesus anywhere? By worshiping and engaging in God's word and by talking to him? That's amazing.
Yeah, it is amazing. Jesus is here, ready, inviting us to discover him. And now we get to say yes.
Jesus, I need you.
That's right, Argyle. Just like Andrew and Peter and James and John in this story, discovering Jesus is our first step to becoming part of a movement of hope. Guys, when we discover Jesus, we discover hope. Because do you remember what hope is?
Hope is expecting to see God's goodness in your life. Jesus is hope.
That's right. Jesus is hope. Jesus is God's goodness in our life. We need his hope, and the world needs his hope. But before we can share his hope with others, we get to discover it for ourselves.
Well, I can't wait to get started on my journey of discovering Jesus.
Yeah, it's pretty awesome. You know, Argyle, we can actually get started right now. See, Jesus is here, like we said, and he's with us, ready to spend time with us. So how about we all worship him together?
Oh yes, of course, I want to. All right, come on kids, let's all stand up.
Yes, let's all stand up and worship. Jesus is the most important thing in our life. So let's worship him with our voices by singing and with our bodies by dancing and focus our hearts on him. Here we go.
Let's go.
I only wanna see what you see. I only wanna say what you say. I only wanna do what you do, Jesus. I only wanna think like you think. I only wanna love like you love. I only wanna live how you live, Jesus. Your word will guide me. It's not just a story, a lamp unto my feet, a brand new discovery. Let the journey begin.
Hey, we love worshiping with you guys. So everybody can go ahead and have a seat.
Mm-hmm. Now, kids, you know how we were talking about hope today?
Yeah, hope is expecting to see God's goodness in our life because Jesus is hope.
Before we go, let's all read Romans 15:13 from the Bible, God's word, and invite him to fill us with hope. May the God of hope fill you with all joy and peace as you trust in him, so that you may overflow with hope by the power of the Holy Spirit. Romans 15:13. Everybody, we're going to pray. Let's close our eyes so that we can tune out all distractions and focus on God. Dear God, thank you so much for giving us your son Jesus to fill us with hope so that we may overflow with hope to others.
Jesus, thank you that you are hope. And so everywhere that we go, hope follows. It's in Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
All right, in a few seconds, some questions are gonna pop up on the screen so you can talk about what we learned today.
Thanks for joining us today. Go this week always remembering, say them with me if you know it, that
God is good,
that Jesus has forgiven me, that
I am loved, and everything is possible.
Bye.
Bye guys, see you next week.